Hello, good afternoon, good evening, everybody. It's Tuesday, in case you lost track of time. I remember because I just saw my calendar. I forgot just now, so I looked at the diary. It's 7th of April. We're on the 7th of April, 2020. This is going to be the second week of our next 90-day goal, second quarter of this year. All right, so when we work with our clients, it's about working on every 90 days of our year. So that's how we can set goals, achieve them, and stock take and be prepared. Okay, this is something that I would like to share because I noticed that in myself in the past, and also and a lot of the people that I, you know, sometimes that I work with as well, they come to me when they're desperate. They start like, oh, there's no way I gotta earn my 5,000 this month itself. Otherwise, I'm gonna lose my this. I'm gonna lose my house or car, whatever it is. You know, and they are in that state of fear and desperation. Okay, and why did this happen? Is because a lot of things that happened before in the past that were signs or signals, but they didn't look out for it, they didn't notice it, or they just purposely don't want to notice it. They purposely ignore it, and then it became a crisis. So don't let your life be hit by crisis, because I mentioned this before in the past in some of my last Facebook lives, that people are they're comfortable in their discomfort. They are not comfortable, but they're still in comfort zones, right? They are uncomfortable in their comfort zones. And when you are uncomfortable in your comfort zones and you don't do anything about it, that's where crisis happens. And that's when the crisis happens, that's, you know, the person start to panic, start to be desperate, start to clang kabut, no, rush here, rush there, and it's like get very angry. So that is not the kind of energy that you want to have when you want to attract good things in your life. And when you are in that state, in that energy, in that fear-based energy, that's where a lot of things happen. You know, you're getting more stuck, a lot more fear, you attract danger, you attract unnecessary negative things and all that. So be aware of the energy that you put out there as well, okay? So don't wait until crisis happens, then klang kabut, oh, rushing here, rushing there and all that. And I saw this, I was reminded of this because I saw this video that Trevor Noah of The Daily Show posted on his Instagram yesterday, and I saw that it was actually very interesting to reflect on. And that video was actually, well, the purpose of that video was more political, but I saw it as something that was already there. People saw things that could happen, but they chose to ignore it. They chose not to take precautions. They chose to think that, you know, other people face that problem, it won't happen to me. And then when it does, that's where, you know, people start to, oh, I gotta do something about it, and it's too late. Right, so don't get your life in that state all the time, whether it's your health. Even if you're very healthy right now, you're strong, you've got six packs and all that, you know, you look invincible, you're gonna get over any disease, or you think, right? Don't take your health for granted. You gotta, you know, be aware of what you need to do to make sure you take care of your health so that crisis doesn't happen where, you know, you suddenly need to you know, you go to the hospital and get treated for something that you didn't take care of in your health. Don't take your relationships for granted. And sometimes most people, because they are in their comfort zones, they take people for granted and say, you know, I'm already married to this person, the person knows me already, I don't need to work on the relationship. And then crisis happens, and then you try to fix it. Oh, you know, you try to get a marriage coach and stuff like that, and it takes a lot more effort to bring the relationship back together, right? So don't wait until that happens to have a good marriage. Even when you see certain signs, you got to address it right from the beginning, right? So you make sure that you don't hit that crisis. When it comes to your knowledge, your mindset, your education also, keep learning so that you don't get to a point where I don't know nothing. I don't know anything about the internet. I don't know how to operate a video call. You know, so as even if there's no urgency for you to learn the internet or technology, I say just learn anyway, just to keep updated, because you don't know what will happen. Like right now, for example, who knew 2 months ago that they need to get their business all online? Who knew just 2 months ago that they need to be homeschooled and learn online, when, you know, there were already available platforms before that, but people were not willing to learn. I don't need lah, you know, this kind of thing. Maybe they need, I'm good enough, you know. And then when things happen like that, then they clang kabut. Oh, clang rushing. Oh, how you operate this? What am I supposed to learn? What am I supposed to download? So all of these things, don't allow urgency or crisis to happen before you start taking any actions, just because you think it's not going to happen to you. And one of the most important things that I would like to remind you is, don't wait for you to be close to God to strengthen your spirituality, strengthen your faith. And a lot of times people say, I don't need, you know, I'm okay, my life is good already, I don't believe in all of this other stuff, you know, I am, you know, I'm good enough, I don't want any, I'm still young, I can go back to God when I'm older, you know, things like this, where people take spirituality for granted. And when crisis happens, that's when they start, oh, meditation lah, they start to, wanting to go back. Don't wait, because in our lives, as long as we're building our relationships, our health, taking care of our health, working on our knowledge, our education, our mindsets, and strengthening our spirituality, and having faith, that inner faith in all of us, strengthen that faith in us, you will be more grounded. You will be able to handle any crisis, because you have already prepared for something in the past. Don't wait for yourself to become desperate for something if you haven't prepared for something that you didn't expect before. All right, so those are basic tips. So what you start noticing now that needs to be taken care of, whether to pivot your business, creating another income, making sure your children are comfortable with online learning, all of these things, be aware and work in how you can put that together into your whole lifestyle, into your families, get everyone on board, and be happy about it. Don't be in a state of fear and anger, you know, because as long as you're strengthening your relationship with our Almighty, our loving Creator, God, you know, everything is meant for you. Everything is meant for the greater good. Everything that's happening is meant for the greater good. Have that faith, have that belief, be in a state of happiness, be in a state of gratitude, always add value to others, make sure you are reaching out and helping people in your life. Whatever you have, you think you don't have enough, there's somebody else who's worse off than you, and of course there's somebody who's better off than you. So you have what you have, and you can add value to others with what you already have. Okay, so with that, have a wonderful day. I'm going to be breaking my fast really soon, and I hope you all have a wonderful dinner. And for the rest of you who are just starting your day, have a wonderful morning. I'm so happy to see you all here. Hello, Aisha. Hello, Nazira. Hello, Kelvin, Bobby, Zalina, nice to see you. Benny, Charles, Jeff, Zaliza, Rufi, Laila, and Philson, and Zil. Love you all. Have a wonderful day. Stay safe, stay at home, and spread love and respect. Bye.